I can't even imagine what this would do to your mother. But I don't have to worry about that, do I? Because she's not with us anymore. And your sister. Oh God, your sister. It hasn't even been a year since her death, Laurel. And you know, it takes everything I've got not to crawl back inside that bottle every night. And it takes everything I've got to wake up sober every morning. And do you know why? Because I still have you, my baby girl. We have each other. We have trust. Or at least I thought we did.
Please, then I need you to listen to me.
Get called into the station and find out from one of my detectives, no less, that you're sitting handcuffed in my interrogation room. Not only have you been lying to me about the drugs, but now you've been arrested? What the hell do you want from me, Laurel?
I know what this looks like, but you have to listen to me. I know what's happening. Sebastian, he's setting me up because he knows I'm onto him. He's trying to frame me.
By planting drugs in your apartment.
No, forget about the drugs. The point is that he is the one behind this witch hunt.
Sebastian is the one who called your boss. He's worried about you.
No, he wasn't worried about me. He's trying to discredit me. Don't you see what he's doing?
What I see is you tested positive for opiates. I see you're still lying to me. I see that you've been stealing from me.
I can explain that.
Everyone that sits where you're sitting now says the same thing.
Dad.
The DUI, this paranoia about Sebastian. You're looking like hell, Laurel. Laurel. Laurel! You have a problem. It's addiction. It runs in the family. You can't pin this one on Sebastian.
Daddy, please, I need you to believe me. Please.
I don't, baby.